About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening, and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And boy, it's hard to believe it's January already. Where the heck did the year go? I trust all of you had a wonderful holiday, and we do have a program this evening. Our guests are Joan Heater and Mike Kreiser. Now, they were both on our program, probably last August, when we were talking about obedience trial champions and agility champions. Well, we didn't exactly get very much done with, we took up too much time on obedience and didn't get enough agility. So this evening, we're going to be talking about all about agility. Joan, I think we'll talk to you first, and you can tell us what breed of dog you have, since this is, I don't know if you can see her or not, she's laying down, so it looks like a little black lump.
Yes, she's a little lump.
Maybe you can get her
Joan,
up.
Joan, can you stand
little...
up? Turn this way, honey. This way.
Yeah,
there we go. That one is a Portuguese water dog. They were originally way, way back herding dogs that migrated to the coast of Portugal and ended up in fishing boats, where they proceeded to herd fish instead of sheep.
Oh.
So they were a pretty rare breed for a while. Mm-hmm. There were very few of them left in the world until they were brought to the United States in the early 70s. And now they're pretty easy to find. There's a lot of them around. They're real nice dogs. They're smart, easy to work with.
And they're good working
and
dogs. Yeah,
dogs.
They have a nice work ethic. Easy to train.
Yeah.
Right. And they don't shed.
No, they don't shed.
Right. They don't shed. So it's like a poodle, but it doesn't shed. Okay. And Mike, you want to tell us who you have, especially the little one?
Okay. The little one is Swoosh. She is 9 weeks old, and she's a Labrador Retriever. And down below is my yellow lab, Yoshi. He is 6 years old. My labs are more along the lines of the American Field Labs, rather than the European labs.
Yeah, they're longer and thinner and taller, actually, than the English type labs, which
yes,
are shorter and stockier. These are way better for agility work than the shorter, stockier ones.
Yes.
Okay. You get more speed?
More speed. They can take the jumping
and
running a little bit better
for
longer periods of time.
Okay. All right, very good. So, now that we know who you have, maybe you'd like to explain to us what is agility. Now, some of you people probably have Animal Planet, and you know what agility is. But there are other people, like me, who don't have cable, and they have no idea what we're talking about when we say agility. So would you like to just give us a little rundown of what agility is?
Nope.
Either one of you.
There's a timed course, and a course consists of anywhere from about 15 to 20 obstacles. You have jumps, you have what looks like a seesaw, tunnels, and various other obstacles that you have a timed amount of seconds to complete.
Okay. And you have to do all of the obstacles? You can't sort of cheat? You have to
no.
do them all? Okay.
You're given a course map
the
beginning of the day to study and to walk, and you have to complete it in a certain order without mistakes or faults.
Okay, so then the obstacles are numbered for you so that you basically know where you're going. When you're looking at the map coincides with the numbers that are on the obstacles in the ring.
That is correct.
Okay, and then you also get a chance to walk through that course to actually walk it and see what you're doing.
Yes, during the walkthrough, that is your time to strategize and determine what works best for you and your dog.
Okay.
There's different crosses and different ways to complete a course.
Okay.
And there's various training methods, and all those are used when you walk and you see various people doing various things to complete the course the same way.
So from the beginning to the end, you do your own thing in between as
yes.
long as you're going. Okay. Now you're saying a cross. That doesn't mean we're going through the ring like this, right?
No.
Okay.
Crossing is to get on another side of an obstacle to get to the next section of jumps or the next section. in the best way for you and your dog.
Okay, so you'd either, with a cross, you'd either be running behind your dog or in front of your dog, so
yes.
that you're crisscrossing the dog. The dog, he's going this way and you're crossing in front of him to get over here to direct him. Oh, we have a home viewer. Okay, come in, home viewer. Hello?
Yeah. Hi. My son just purchased a Lapidoodle. It's a golden Labrador with a large poodle.
Uh-huh.
Is this a new breed or?
No, it's a mixed breed.
It's just a mixed breed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a mix between a Labrador and a poodle. It's just like the Collie Shet mixes. It's just somebody.
Like the old mongrel.
Yep, that's basically it. Yes, I wasn't going to say it that way, but yeah, that's basically what it is.
The dog is tremendously smart.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my.
Yeah, and they're big.
Yep.
And I would suggest that he starts training very, very quickly because they can get very unruly. The activity level of the lab, which you have the jumping and the pulling on leash, the barking, you have to get that under control in a hurry. So I would suggest that he starts training the dog very, very quickly.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh. Okay. Let's go back to agility. There's different classes for the dogs, right?
Like obedience, there's a beginner's class, an intermediate class, and then an advanced class.
Okay.
That way. They call them novice, open, and excellent in agility.
Okay.
And it's like obedience. You start out in the novice class, and then when you get three legs in that class, then you can move up to the open class.
Okay.
Then when you get three qualifying scores,
mm-hmm.
we call them legs,
mm-hmm.
then you move up to the excellent class.
Okay.
When you get to excellent, when you have your three qualifying legs, you move from what they call the A class, which is like an inexperienced excellent dog, into the B class, which they would consider you an experienced person then.
Like all the high rollers.
Yeah, like the high rollers. And there you're stuck. You get nowhere after that.
Okay.
Forever and ever afterwards, you're an excellent B for your lifetime. And when you get into the B classes is when you start accumulating your mock points. And you can get a master's in your B classes when you get 10 qualifying scores in either standard and in jumpers. You get a master's jumpers title and a master's just standard title.
Okay. And is that what the MA stands for?
Yeah. So, and then you just keep accumulating points in that class, and then you go on toward your mock.
Okay.
Some dogs never get to a mock. It depends on how good they are, how consistent they are.
Okay.
To get a mock, you have to have a dog that's relatively fast, but also very consistent.
Right.
And you don't need to beat anybody. Unlike in obedience for an arch, you need to have first places and win your classes to get points, or at least place.
Right.
You get points in agility for every second you're under the course time.
Oh,
and it doesn't matter if you place or not, you still get those points.
Wow.
And they all count toward your mock.
Well, that's wonderful then. So how many points do you need for a mock?
A mock, you need 750 points.
Wow.
That's why you need a relatively good fast dog. But on top of the points, you also need to do 20 double Qs.
Double Q is
we need to backtrack.
Q is qualifying.
You have in AKC agility, you have two runs a day, a jumper's run and a standard run.
Okay.
Jumpers is just jumps and tunnels and weave poles.
Okay.
In the standard classes, you have the things like the teeter and the dog walk and the apron, which are contact obstacles. You don't have that in jumpers. So you have these two classes that you get to run. You have to qualify in both of them on the same day, which is a double Q.
Okay.
And you have to do that 20 times, plus your 750 points, to get a mock.
Wow.
Which is why you have to have a consistent dog.
Yes. You also have to have a fair amount of money.
Oh, yeah. Mocks are real expensive. A lot like arches. Yes. Costs you lots of bucks.
Yes, it does. To get 750 points, it's like, wow. So if you have a fast dog that's not consistent, that's missing, then you're not good. I mean, you'll continue on and on and on until you get a dog that really, I mean, until the dog actually realizes that it has to qualify each time, or you realize that, you know, you better quit because your dog's not going to qualify each time.
Which is why not everyone has one.
It's tough.
Yeah, it is. It's not an easy thing.
Right. And now they also have, like, Mach 1s and Mach 2.
Yeah, you can keep going. Once you get your 20 double Qs, you just keep, your points keep going. You don't start over again.
Oh.
So as long as your points keep going, Devlin, I think Devlin has enough points for 10 mocks at this point.
Oh my goodness.
But she only has 5 with double Qs.
Okay.
So.
Okay. So then if you, once you get to like 1500 points, then you have a mock two. Is that how it
goes?
Oh, okay. Then what happens?
But you need the double Qs too.
Okay.
You can, once you have the 1500 points, then you need 40 double Qs.
Okay.
20 more.
Okay.
So you just keep going.
So each time, once you get your Mach 1, then you have to get the 20 double Qs plus the additional 750 mm-hmm. points.
Just keeps going.
Okay. Okay. All right. Well, that's as confusing as mud, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wow. Somebody keeps track of these points, right?
Yes, the AKC keeps track of them. And we do, too.
Yeah,
everybody keeps track of their points.
Yeah, these are both purebreds. What about if you have, like the man who called, he said he has a...
Mr. Doodle?
His son has a one of the doodles. So, and it's...
There are other organizations that accept mixed breed dogs.
Okay.
There's USDAA.
Okay.
And NADAC.
Okay.
And there's a couple other ones, too. There's a Canadian one. I forget what that one's called. They have different requirements for different titles. Basically, they have the same classes. USDAA has more games classes than we have. AKC has one games class. It's called FAST.
Okay.
It's like USDAA gamblers. They have a whole lot of different things. They have tournaments. You can go to regional tournaments and get into the nationals for USDAA, the same way we have AKC nationals.
Oh,
right. It's just they have different rules and different different requirements for their titles.
So how would somebody find out about?
Everybody's got a website.
Just
go in on the websites, yeah. And AKC, you can go in and pick up agility on the AKC website, and you'll find rules
So even if you did go into like akc.org and went into agility, they would give you like who to contact for the NADAC and US?
Oh, probably not.
Oh, okay. All right. They're actually,
if you want an all-purpose website for all the agility organizations, uh-huh. Clean Run has everything.
So that's cleanrun.com.
Clean Run is an agility magazine. It's a premier magazine. It's got everybody's training methods in it. It's got everything you want. If you go in on their website, you can find anything you need.
Wow. Okay. There you are, sir. All you need to do is have your son go into www.cleanrun.com and he can find out all about agility, and that would be wonderful exercise for his dog. So also something else to do. So then you can get, like, if I was a beginner and I'm going in with my first dog, if I qualify 3 times, what do I get? You understand what I say? You know, when I go into obedience mm-hmm. and I qualify 3 times, I get a CD on my dog.
Yes.
Okay. Now I'm going into agility.
Okay.
And I qualify 3 times. What do I get?
You would get a novice, an NA.
Okay.
Yours is CD is companion dog.
Uh-huh.
Novice agility is novice agility,
NA. Okay. Okay.
And if you get your jumpers title, it's NAJ for jumpers.
Okay.
Then when you go up through, it's OA and OAJ uh-huh. and excellence, or not E, they're AXJ, NAX.
AX.
And then masters is MA and, no, MX and MXJ.
Oh.
And then the mocks are MACH. Master agility champion.
Yeah, well, the MACH, that one the other ones that I didn't have.
They have a new class called Preferred for dogs who aren't quite making time or cannot quite jump the jump height they're required to jump via their size.
Okay.
AKC measures your dog at the withers, mm-hmm. and from that they determine what jump height you should be jumping. And there's some breeds out there like Basset Hounds which cannot jump right. as high as they're supposed to at their withers.
Mm-hmm.
So they created a preferred class for them.
And that was nice.
Everything that she mentioned as far as titles, I think, are all the same except there's a P.
Yeah,
there's a P.
They even have mock for those dogs now called mm-hmm. a PAX. Yep. PAX.
Huh.
So when you have when your dog gets older and you don't want to jump it, it's, you know, regular height, you think it's too much for the dog, mm-hmm. you can drop it down 4 inches and still get all the titles you had before.
So is that what the standard is, 4 inches? Does it drop down?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the jump heights are in 4
well,
inches.
Well, you know, if I had a chihuahua, how high would it have to jump?
It would depend on how high it is at the withers.
Okay, but a chihuahua is only about 8 inches at the withers.
Okay, is there
a minimum?
Yes, okay. There are, but I don't know what the little ones are.
Oh, yeah.
I don't
you would have a little one like
no,
that.
No, and they changed some of them because the, yes. because of mostly
corgis.
Because of the corgis. The corgi, a lot of the corgis had to jump 12 inches,
uh-huh.
and that's a little much for a corgi
yes.
to throw itself over a 12-inch jump.
Yes.
So they raised the shoulder height for the 8-inch class to 11 instead of 10,
yes.
and now most of the corgis fit in the 8-inch class.
Oh,
so it was to alleviate some of the big chested mm-hmm, dogs mm-hmm. that are short-legged
yeah, yeah.
from you know having all that stress on right, their limbs and things.
Yeah, well, it certainly would
yeah,
be because you
lot.
Have a lot of weight coming down on those little bitty legs. So the
yeah.
same with the Bassets.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it would be the same like with the giant breeds, too. The Great Pyrenees, not that you have a Great Pyrenees running, but...
Oh, yeah.
You
know,
yes.
You know. Yeah, they do.
Do they run?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. Great.
Leonbergers.
Well...
they do. They run Leonbergers. And Great Danes. You see mm-hmm. Great Danes out in California a lot.
Really?
Not around here so much, but there's some nice Danes out in California
huh.
that do it. And
that's
they interesting. And 24, well, 26 is the top jump height, but 24 is all you need to do. 26 is just an optional height.
Yeah, yeah. Well, probably would be very difficult for a peer to jump 26.
No, but 24 is not that much different, really.
Yeah,
24 is a lot, but yeah, but they do. They
really?
Have some, yeah.
Wow, you would think they would go into the preferred class. I can't
some of
imagine,
them do.
Yeah.
Some of them do.
Can't imagine having them because with agility, I mean, with obedience, they don't have. They only have to jump their height.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, they only have to jump their height.
Yeah.
Right. I'm trying to think of what my dog jumps. But no, she jumps 24 and she's 23 at the shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
So they must only have to jump 3/4 their height.
Well,
I don't remember.
But in obedience, Devlin has to jump higher than she jumps in agility. Because she's 18 inches tall, she'd have to jump 18, but she fits into the 16-inch class.
Oh.
So she actually does less in agility than she would in obedience.
Well, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Good for her.
If I didn't want to jump Maisie at 24, I could go down to 22?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But
no,
then
20.
I have
It'd
to be
20.
20.
20
oh.
is the next one down.
Oh, okay.
22 would be your USDA.
Oh, oh, they go every 2 inches then.
No, they have they different.
Much.
They're different.
Oh, okay.
We don't do a whole
okay.
lot of that, so we don't
okay.
know.
Okay. So then would I be in the preferred class?
Yes. If you wanted to jump
okay,
20, you would just list her as preferred instead of standard, the regular classes.
Okay. Well, I would think that would be easier on all the breeds, shoulder-wise. You know, they're always coming down on the shoulders, and depending how often you're at a show, you know, if you go every weekend, it's probably going to be, well, not only wear and tear on them, but wear and tear on you as well, because you're running with them.
Yeah, jump heights don't shit bother us.
Yeah.
We don't have to do the jumps.
No, you have to do the jump. You just have to run. So then when you're scoring, with the scoring, they have to do every single thing, even in the novice class?
Mm-hmm.
Is it like the
yes.
same like with obedience, that
yes.
they must do every single thing? If they miss one,
yeah.
that disqualifies them?
No.
Oh.
No. In the excellent classes, you have to be perfect.
Okay.
You can't make any mistakes. You have to run, I think the only thing you can have wrong anymore in excellent is time faults, so in A, right?
Yes.
But all the B classes, you have to be perfect.
Okay.
In novice, you're allowed three mistakes, I think.
Oh,
and
wow.
they cost you 5 points.
Okay.
You have to have an 85 to qualify in novice and open.
Okay.
So you can make 3 mistakes, but there's certain mistakes, like you can have 2 refusals or 2 wrong courses but only 3 of them. I don't know. I haven't been in novice a while, Pat. It's been a while. So
but you do have to complete
you
the
have
course
to complete
in
the
number
course.
Order.
Yeah.
There's mistakes that are given to you, but you do have to complete the course
okay.
number order.
Okay. So if my dog, when you're saying a refusal, if she went up to a tunnel and didn't go through,
that would be a refusal. Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Or if you were running and you were supposed to go in the tunnel and she took a jump instead, that would be a wrong course.
Okay.
Anytime you go off of where the course is supposed to be going, that's a wrong course. That's 5 points. The refusal would cost you 5 points.
But I would have to, if she took the wrong jump, would mm-hmm. I have to go back to
you would
what
have
I
to,
had missed, what,
yes.
what we did wrong?
Yeah, you just
okay.
go back to the one that you missed. Used to be they weren't so fussy about doing more than that.
Mm-hmm.
Like sometimes if you're going to go back and try to pick something up that you missed and your dog takes an extra something before that, They used to just let that go, but now they think it's training in the ring. So if you do something, like if you would go, if you were only supposed to be doing one jump that you missed and your dog swung around and took another one before that, then now they blow you off and they don't let you finish your run. So so you have to be a little careful about where you go back and fix things. But
well, this is why we have classes, right?
Yes, to teach you guys what to do before you get in the ring. It's complicated. It's not, agility isn't like obedience where you go in the ring every time and do the same routine. Mm-hmm. Obedience, you can pattern train your dog and it never changes. Right. When you go into an agility ring, your course is different every time.
Okay.
And that's why you need so many different skills to do agility, mm-hmm. because every time you go in, you do something another way.
Okay.
It's not jump, 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 tunnel mm-hmm. every time. It's mm-hmm. sometimes it's you go one way, sometimes you go the other way. And your dog just has to read your body language that much more than you need
yes.
to do in obedience.
Yes.
It's a little more complicated.
Yeah. Well, it's a whole different style of training.
It is.
It's a whole different style.
Your dog has to actually be able to work on its own at certain points.
Right.
They need to understand that they can just go on and do things without you being right on top of them all the time the way you are in an obedience
ring.
That might be
hard for some dogs.
It is, because not all of them like to be away from
you. That's exactly right, and especially if you're doing obedience training, mm-hmm. your dog is used to working very close by, taking all the commands, whereas when you're doing agility, they have to be out there mm-hmm. jumping over the jumps, and it's like, whoa, we can't do this. We have to stay right here on your left side. So I would think that would be very difficult for some breeds.
It was hard when I did my first 40 in mm-hmm. agility, because he was, up until he was 5 years old, all he had done was obedience.
Yes.
And when we started doing agility, you need to work on both sides, not just mm-hmm. your left side. And he didn't understand that I had a right side, you know? He was always over here. What's over here? Nothing, you know?
Yes.
So it was hard to break him of the habit of being on that side all the time. But once he understood that he could work off of both sides, it was great, uh-huh. because all uh-huh. of his obedience training just fed right into what we needed to do with agility. So you do need obedience training for agility.
Yes, well, certainly, because they have to pay attention.
Yes.
But the main thing in agility and the main thing in
yes,
obedience is
attention.
The dog paying attention
yes.
to you.
But then you just need to, it's more variation
yes.
in agility than
yes,
it is
most
in obedience.
Definitely. And I would guess people who do, like breed showing, the dog has to be on your left and your right. So they, you know, if you're showing in breed, you also might have a little bit of a, you know, an edge there that the dog is already used to working on both sides. Or if you're doing like freestyle with the doggy dancing, there again, the dog would be on both sides. So mm-hmm. that might help you too. So mm-hmm. well, who knows? Anyhow, the ages that you can start training a dog. Now you are the training director, the agility training director for the dog training club.
Yes.
Right. And you are one of the instructors.
Yes.
Okay. So how soon would you start training a dog? Are you training Swoosh?
Training her to sit
okay.
and to touch for the contacts at the bottom.
Very good.
So starting with, if she touches my hand in any way, shape, or form, rewarding that.
Mm-hmm.
And just trying to get drive out of her with toys and tug toys and just fundamental things as of right now. I have a small plank set up for her to walk across.
Okay.
Just to get her used to walking.
Right,
On, like the dog walk
yes.
in. Been wanting to get the tunnel out just to get her to go mm-hmm. through the tunnel. But
mm-hmm.
there's little things you can start with. You should not have them jumping
no,
heights
for that.
Until, what do you recommend Joan likes?
You can actually like if you have set a bar up on a on a tuna can
mm-hmm.
something just really tiny, they can jump that. I mean, they just walk over that,
right?
So all you're really teaching them to do is go between the two standards of the jump, and it doesn't really matter what height it is as long as they learn to go in between
mm-hmm.
and tunnels, and you can put your A-frame or your dog walk way down and have them walking on that just so they don't get hurt falling off the sides
yes,
and stuff
yes. Yes.
But yeah, we start our puppies way early.
Yeah.
As soon as they come in the house. I do anyway. I don't know. I know Mike does too.
Yes, yes. Well, you would almost have to. You know, it's like with learning the piano or
mm-hmm.
speaking another language. Children always learn it so much faster,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
you know, when they're young, and puppies are the same way, you know. You
yep.
Plus it gives them an outlet, something to do besides chewing on your hands.
And it builds your relationship as well.
Yes, it does. And now you were talking about drive. How are you getting her, like throwing a toy for her, is that?
Yes, I'm throwing a toy and actually throwing a toy for him and having her chase him.
Oh, okay.
And that's the main way right now, but a tug toy and pulling
uh-huh.
and tugging with her as well. But mainly just throwing toys for him, and she's chasing after.
Wow, that's great.
It's amazing how well your old dog teaches your new dog.
Oh yes. Good and bad, right?
Yes.
Now, you both went to... We're not going to have enough time to show these DVDs. Maybe we ought to show them now. These are these two dogs running at the Invitationals, which was in California, right?
Yes.
Okay. Let's show the DVDs quickly.
2 minutes.
What a good it is.
This is just a jumper's course.
So you have your weed pole.
Really well.
No, it's not running really well. Okay. Is that all? Wasn't there another one on that one?
There were four of them on there.
Four
we'll
of
try
them.
It again.
Okay.
Actually, there were five on one there.
Just so you get some idea of the speed and basically what you're doing.
And Invitationals.
This is
Yoshi's run. This is a standard run. Here is the dog walk. There's a yellow section at the touch. Jumping through the tire, coming through. This is an example of a cross. Didn't show that part. And
that's
a
rear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this is a jumper's course.
You see his way. That's when you get to breathe.
Through the tunnel, yes. Now we're coming up through the tire. This is just a breakdown of my two runs. It wasn't actually a full run.
It was
my mock run, which I complete the 20 double Qs and the points as shown earlier, so you get to keep the bar after you're done as a gift. Let's just say that you was well earned.
Yes, that you paid a lot for, right?
Yes,
definitely.
There we go, Mach 3 Yoshi, very good.
Actually, it was funny that day because Devlin got her Mach 5 the same day Mike got his Mach 3.
Oh my word.
Yes. We had a good week.
Wow. Well, we still didn't, I guess we covered most of what we wanted to cover. We still didn't really cover the Invitationals, but I guess we'll save that for another day. Since our time ran out, I think we got a lot of information. And for you who are interested in doing agility, please call the Berks County Dog Training Club. I guess you probably will have a class starting...
Probably late April, early May.
Late April, early May. Okay, so that's our program for this evening. So, good night.
All About Dogs on VCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.